Hey everybody, I'm Scott Hanselman. This is another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Christina Compy, and we're going to talk about app service hybrid connections.
Yes.
It's a hybrid cloud. What are the hybrid connections?
Hybrid connections gives you access to resources in other networks. So you can have resources on-premise or in customer networks that you want your application to have access to, or that your customers are giving you access to.
So it's not necessarily other networks within Azure itself. This is always outside Azure?
It doesn't have to be outside Azure. You could use it within Azure. You could use it from a competitor. You could use it from on-premise. You can have up to 200 hybrid connections in an individual app. And it gives you access, secure access, to TCP endpoints. This is a host port endpoint, right? So it's not giving you network access from your app to another network. It's giving you access directly to a single host and port.
Oh, okay, so this is even more refined than just like I'm in a VPN site to site.
It's like a
wormhole from one network to another network.
Right. Exactly correct. It's a secure wormhole directly to an application endpoint. And hybrid connections doesn't care whether you're doing SQL or web protocol. It's TCP based. So
interesting.
You can go access a MySQL database, your Oracle database. We had a customer access a mainframe endpoint.
That was my next question, because I used to work in banking, and we would talk to back-end mainframes and AS400s and all kinds of stuff. As long as I know my port range, that's totally okay as well.
Well, it's not a range, though. It's a specific port, right?
Okay.
So it's an actual host and port combination for each hybrid connection endpoint.
Okay.
Now, you can have, like I said, up to 200 of them, but if you were doing like SQL named database instances and you had port redirection, you'd have to have a hybrid connection for both the 1433 port and the redirection port.
Okay, but 200 is a pretty good amount, and I could make little pseudo ranges if need be.
It's true.
Interesting.
And it's way better and secure than open-ended access to a network from your app.
Okay, so if I'm sure there's consultants that are watching who have had experiences with clients where the client has said, I don't really feel comfortable yet putting my data in the cloud. Mm-hmm. Let's let the work happen in the cloud, but I really want my data on premises. That's something that would be used for hybrid connections?
Yeah. Or if you're a developer and you wanted to quickly prototype something, hybrid connections lets you access resources, even on your local workstation without having to set up and configure a VPN connection up to Azure. So this is something that it's really simple to set up and get going without all the overhead of, putting a internet accessible endpoint there for that is a possible hack entry.
That's a good point. I've actually done that a couple times where I've had a Mongo database running and I set up a DMZ locally in my house. Probably not the smartest idea. I could have my little Mongo database, throw my website up in the cloud, and then punch a hole and I'm off.
Right. Since the protocol for hybrid connections is WebSockets, you probably don't even need to punch a hole.
Oh, really?
So it's all over 443. TLS 1.2, and you have secure access outbound from your network where you install the relay agent.
So there's no firewall stuff I have to do.
Not unless you're blocking outbound to the internet, in which case that's...
then you got bigger problems.
Right. It really limits your network usefulness.
All right, cool. Let's see a demo if you got one.
Sure. I've got a real quick, easy demo. So everybody's familiar with WordPress. Mm-hmm. WordPress uses a back-end MySQL database. Mm-hmm. And so in this case, the back-end MySQL database is sitting on a workstation under my desk in a Microsoft campus building somewhere.
This is real.
This is real. This is live demo. This isn't paper mache. So
this is on the outside. It's .azurewebsites.net. That's real. But the database that holds that is under your desk.
That's right. And so you just saw it work. And we can do the negative scenario where we're going to break it.
Oh, okay.
Because,
you don't know if it's real unless you break it.
I know. It's a lot more believable if you break something.
Okay. So you're just going into hybrid connections. You had two. Now you have one.
Right. I deleted the one that goes to my MySQL database, which, by the way, it uses the, pointing to my screen is going to do anything. Host and port that you define for your hybrid connection in your app. So my app is making a lookup and a call to, in this case, Compy Workstation 1433. That's not an internet accessible endpoint. But in the public cloud, we catch that, redirect it, send it through the hybrid connection. So as long as it resolves where my hybrid connection manager is installed, then it works.
Okay, so let me see if I can paraphrase and understand. It'll go and do a DNS lookup effectively to like foo. Foo doesn't exist. It's not even a fully qualified domain name. It's just like an intranet name. You notice it, you tunnel it through the wormhole under your desk.
As long as it resolves on the hybrid connection manager, it'll make it out there. And so basically, you can define any endpoint you want in your hybrid connection and lift and shift it.
Is there something running under your desk that is allowing that to happen?
Well, I do have a workstation named Compy Workstation.
I understand that. But how did it know?
Oh,
like,
how
is
did
there
it
like
know?
A tray icon or something or a service?
Yeah, well, so there, when I build the hybrid connection in the first place, I define that host and port. And then there is a agent that runs on side and that's what we call the Hybrid Connection Manager, which you can download it here in the Hybrid Connection Manager UI.
Okay.
And it looks looks beautiful.
So the Hybrid Connection Manager registers that known name, and then that's allowing the magic tunneling. So this is your desk. Oh, and there it is.
Right.
All right, cool. And there's it right there.
Right. And so both of them are still connected. I just disconnected it from my app.
So if you hit refresh, would it disappear?
No, it's going to stay there because it's still connected. The agent running on my computer is still connected, supporting these to the cloud. So it's connected to the cloud, supporting those items.
Okay.
So if I was to go then, wrong one, back to the application.
All right.
And refresh it. All I have done so far is break the database connection, and so we've proven failure, or proven with a failure.
How fast is it? Is it fast enough for production?
Yes, we have customers using it around the world for production needs. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't stream videos through it, of course, but you know, it does handle a fair amount of data. It's roughly about the same as a VPN, small scale VPN connection. Mm-hmm. But since you can have so many of them from your web app, it gives you a lot of versatility. So like, let's say you're doing inventory management and you have supplier databases all around the world, then this is a nice, easy way that you can touch their database with their permission if they set it up to collect that and then front it out through a single web application.
And it's totally secure, like you said. It's over, it's SSL, and it's locked down. Do I need to worry about anyone sniffing that traffic on the way? There's no man in the middle?
No man in the middle attacks. It's secured with SAS keys for connections. It's secured with TLS 1.2, so it's current and up to date in terms of encryption technologies. Mm-hmm. And I would say it's even more secure than you would consider a VPN, which is also a SSL connection.
Right.
But there's always a internet endpoint involved, right? So you have to have an internet endpoint for like a site-to-site connection where you're connecting between Azure or any public cloud and a private cloud. In this case, because you have an agent, a relay agent operating in your own network that connects outbound to Azure, you don't have to worry about an inbound IP address that's hackable or sniffable. Not that I would say VPNs are hackable, sniffable, I just feel more secure with something like hybrid connections than I do with pretty much all the other connectivity technologies.
Yeah, interesting. So it works. It's non-specific to technology. It doesn't care about the database. It's TCP level. So anything, if I had a custom service that I'd written with my own protocol, doesn't matter.
Nope, doesn't matter if you're doing a Java app with a JDBC call or a .NET app making an Oracle call.
I wonder if there are databases that are so legacy that I couldn't run them in the cloud, so this is a totally appropriate thing. Or like you pointed out, mainframes, where they have no business in any kind of cloud scenario. And what about from a privacy perspective? Would this allow me to maybe be compliant for things when I couldn't be compliant, depending on what my country?
Yeah, this is certified and compliant. So Azure Relay, which this is built upon, is certified and compliant. It's up to date. I don't remember the list, so I don't want to call out all the lists, but is definitely, we discussed this recently, but
it's so you said Azure Relay. That's what this is built on.
Yeah. So Hybrid Connections is actually offered as a subservice of Azure Relay, and then the variant app service Hybrid Connections is a variant thereof, where we lock it down to just a host and port. You can't use this to reach up to the cloud from on premise. This doesn't give you private site access. What this does give you, though, is secure access to remote resources from your app. And we've locked down the entire system to behave that way.
Mm-hmm. When you were back over in your over here, it said that you had 25, and then you had said something about 200. Does it depend on what app service I have?
Right. Well, it depends on what app service plan level you have. So in a basic plan, you can get up to 5. In a standard plan, you can have up to 25. In a premium plan or isolated, you can get up to 200.
Certainly more than enough to do stuff like a WordPress website.
Right, right. Way more. WordPress is using 1. So. Though right now this one's configured for a SQL system, but yes.
All right, very cool. And this exists today and people can use it today?
This exists today. It's fully supported. It is a GA feature and capability, and we look forward to more people using it in the future.
Very cool. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
I am learning all about hybrid connections and app service here on Azure Friday.